Here we are again. Thank you for joining me for this Bible study. And today we're going to talk about the qualities of a true believer. So let's get right into the Word of God. 2 Timothy 2, 24 through 26. And a servant of the Lord must not quarrel, but be gentle to all, able to teach, patient, in humility correcting those who are in opposition, if God perhaps will grant them repentance, so that they may know the truth, and that they may come to their senses and escape the snare of the devil, having been taken captive by him to do his will. A quarrel translates into a military term for hand-to-hand combat, fighting. As the Lord's servants, we're not doing battle with words, but instead, God encourages us to be gentle and be kind to all people. Correcting means training or bringing to maturity. Those who are in opposition are those who place themselves in conflict and against the preaching of Jesus Christ and the Word of God. The aim of God correcting us is repentance, or a change in thought, a change in habit, or eliminating some things in our life that go against God's written word. Come to their senses, or become sober again. False teaching, it has an intoxicating effect on us because we're hearing things that go against God's word, make it a little bit easier to be a Christian. Don't have to do this, don't have to do that. And people interpret it a different way to suit themselves, not to suit the Creator. A snare. Well, a snare is a thing likely to lure or tempt someone. And a snare is also a trap used to capture an animal. And Satan surely has many snares to trip us up. The devil takes captive believers who teach false doctrine, thus leading others astray. He can get one good teacher or preacher off the track, they can influence more people. One of Satan's biggest tactics is to put a division in the church. We all know churches are made up of people. People are imperfect. People have motives. People have desires. And they're not always driven by God. We know that. I encourage you to stay within God's word, stay within the teachings of Jesus Christ, because we are in a war and you're going to have to fight. But we know that Jesus has already won this war for us, and we just have to be faithful to Him, to the Father, and to the Word. That is the word for today. Y'all have a great afternoon.